Ever wonder why 90% of the world's population lives in the Northern Hemisphere? It's a question that's as fascinating as it is complex, leading us into the intricate riddle of global population distribution. This isn't just about people living here or there. No, it's much more. It's about the patterns we humans create on this vast global canvas, patterns that reveal much about our history, our cultures, and our adaptability. Population distribution is a key to understanding our world. It's a magnifying glass that brings into focus the social, economic, and environmental factors shaping our lives. It's a compass that can guide us through our shared past and into our collective future. So, as we embark on this journey, consider yourself an explorer. We're about to traverse the globe, peeling back the layers of human settlement and uncovering the patterns that lie beneath. As we delve into the world of global population distribution, prepare to have your curiosity piqued. Did you know that over two-thirds of the world's population lives in Asia? That's right, a staggering two-thirds. This continent, home to countries like China and India, boasts a population density that far surpasses any other on the globe. The sheer number of individuals living in Asia is a testament to its diverse cultures, landscapes, and opportunities. Yet, not all continents share Asia's bustling population density. Take Australia, for instance, a land of vast open spaces and fewer people. Despite being similar in size to the United States, Australia's population is around the size of Texas. It's a continent where the kangaroos sometimes seem to outnumber the people. Then we have the frosty expanse of Antarctica, the least populated continent. Here, the harsh climate and inhospitable conditions mean that only a small number of scientists and researchers call this icy wilderness home, even if it's just for a few months at a time. Now let's turn our gaze to Africa, a continent of contrasts. Despite being the second largest continent, its population distribution is uneven, with most people living in the fertile regions, while vast desert areas remain scarcely populated. Europe, on the other hand, is relatively small in terms of land area, but it's densely populated. Cities like London, Paris, and Moscow are bustling hubs of people and activity, contributing to Europe's significant global footprint. The Americas, comprising North, Central, and South America, present another interesting case. From the densely populated cities in the United States, to the Amazon rainforest in Brazil, to the sparse populations in the Canadian Arctic, the population distribution here is as varied as the landscape itself. So, why does all this matter? Because understanding population distribution helps us comprehend the dynamics of resource allocation, urban planning, and environmental impact. It informs how we live, where we live, and even how we interact with each other and our planet. As we can see, population distribution is wildly uneven across our globe. This unevenness, this diversity, it's what makes our world so fascinating, so complex, and so incredibly diverse. It's a testament to the adaptability of the human species and a testament to our shared journey on this blue marble we call home. Let's zoom in a bit and examine the population distribution within some of the world's most populous countries. Starting with China, the most populous nation on Earth. It's fascinating to see how the population is distributed across this vast land. The majority of people are concentrated in the eastern coastal regions, where the country's major cities like Beijing, Shanghai, and Guangzhou are located. This area is China's economic powerhouse, bustling with industry and commerce. However, the western part of the country, with its rugged mountains and vast deserts, is sparsely populated. Moving on to India, the second most populous country. India's population distribution is a bit more balanced than China's. Although cities like Mumbai and Delhi are densely populated, the countryside is also teeming with life. In fact, a significant chunk of India's population lives in rural areas, largely due to the country's agrarian economy. But with rapid urbanization, the balance is gradually shifting towards the cities. Next, let's fly over to the United States, the third most populous country. Here, we see a different story. While there are densely populated urban areas on the coast, such as New York City on the east and Los Angeles on the west, there's also a significant population in the heartland. Cities like Chicago in the Midwest and Dallas in the south add to the country's population diversity. The vast open spaces of the Great Plains and mountainous regions, however, are home to fewer people. These examples show the urban-rural divide in population distribution. Cities, with their promise of better job opportunities and services, attract large numbers of people. On the other hand, rural areas, despite having more land, often have fewer people due to less economic activity. This urban-rural divide is not unique to these countries, but is a common trend across the globe. These countries' population distributions are a microcosm of global trends, with densely populated cities contrasting with vast, sparsely populated regions. Population distribution isn't random. There are numerous factors at play. Let's delve a little deeper into what these could be. Climate is a major influencer. Think about it. Would you rather live in a place with moderate temperatures or somewhere with extreme weather conditions? Most people would choose the former, which is why we find large populations in temperate zones. Then, there's topography. The lay of the land impacts where people settle. It's easier to build homes and infrastructure on flat plains than on steep mountains. Hence, regions with rugged terrain often have sparse populations. Another key factor is the availability of resources. Water, fertile soil, minerals, these are essential for survival and development. Areas rich in such resources see higher population densities. Conversely, regions with scarce resources often see less settlement. But remember, these factors can also deter human settlement. Extreme climates, difficult terrain, and resource scarcity can make some places less appealing. Understanding these factors helps us make sense of the curious patterns of global population distribution. Now that we've explored the world of population distribution, what have we learned? We've journeyed through the human hemisphere, the region of the world that holds the majority of our global population. We've highlighted countries where population density is particularly high, such as Bangladesh and Monaco, and we've also touched on nations where it's significantly low, like Mongolia. We've discovered that the distribution of people across our world isn't equal. People cluster in certain areas due to a variety of factors. Many of these factors are environmental, like climate and terrain, while others are socioeconomic, such as job opportunities and political stability. This intricate puzzle of population distribution is ever-changing, shaped by our evolving world and the choices we make as a global society. It's a complex and fascinating subject, offering a unique lens through which we can view our world. As we continue to grow and evolve, so too will our patterns of population distribution. It's a fascinating world out there, isn't it?